Hello everyone, I'm Prem from Dented Code. In previous video, we set up our Windows for fully stack JavaScript environment. And in this video, we're going to install MySQL database in Windows. And we will use Workbench as a user interface to access our database. And we will also look into it how we can access our database and do query from the command line. Okay, let's get started. Let's start installing MySQL. We will get MySQL installer from the MySQL official page. Head over to the URL dev.mysql.com/download. I will put all the links in the description below. Okay, once you are in this MySQL community downloads page, just go installer for Windows. Click on the link. It will take you to the another installation files window. Here we have two options. One is MySQL installer web community and one is installer community. The difference between web community and community only is that the file size. If you have a better internet connection, you use the first link to download. And if you have not really good internet connection, you use this one. Why I'm saying that is because when you use this installation, it will download the installer and downloader. So while you're installing, it will download all the required packages from online and complete the installation. Unlikely, this package has everything within. So when you do install, it has everything it requires to install in the computer. So let's go and download this one because my internet is pretty good. So from here, log in now or sign up for the free account. You don't have to sign in or do anything unless you want to. Just click on no thanks, just start my download. It should start downloading here at the bottom of your web page. Just click on the downloaded file and it will open this prompt window. So saying like MySQL installer community, please wait a while, window configure MySQL installer community. Just wait for a while it's setting up all the environment that require to install MySQL. You will get user account control message if you have set this on. So hit yes. One more time, user account control. I could turn this off, but for the security reason, I would like to leave it default. Optional MySQL installer update available. Just say no for now. Okay, now this is the setup page. So here, please select the setup type that suits your use cases. So look guys, when you're starting, so you don't want to get confused with so many different things, which we will discuss in future. But for now, just install full. Don't even try to understand anything of this one at the moment. Just go full. It will install everything that MySQL has to offer. So hit enter. Next, okay, the pop-up message saying that one of the option is missing. Just say yes for now. And these are the actually features coming with the installation: MySQL Server, MySQL Workbench. Okay, that is long list. Okay, so just execute them and it will start installing here, downloading and installing. If you see like a error here, you can always do try again. Okay, the download and installation process is completed. Let's click next. Just leave the standalone MySQL server. Okay, Okay, this is the networking within your computer. So this one, you are going to use development computer, yes, because you are developing using this computer. The port lib 3306, this is the default port for MySQL. And here, simply just next. Authentication method, use this strong password and encryption for authentication. Don't use the legacy one. Next. Okay, by default, you are root user, so you need to provide password for it. So just type password. So repeat it. It's gonna say weak, but that's fine for me because this is only for development purpose, so it should be fine. This add section, you already have root user coming along with this setup, but if you want to add any user here, you can do it now, but this one we will look into it in the future as well. So just remember the password you put here. Next. So for the service name, I just leave the MySQL 80 as it is. So start the MySQL server, add system startup, yes, and standard system account. Okay, leave this one default, click next and execute all of them. There you go. The configuration for MySQL Server 8.0.20 was successful. Click finish to continue. Yeah, finish it. The server is installed. Now the router and the some sample data. I'll just go next. If I try to explain here, that's probably gonna make you more confused. So rather just let's focus on installing only. Let's hit next. Just click finish. And next. So this one, from here you try to connect to the server which is installed already. The MySQL server is installed already, so if you have to access data visually, you need some sort of interface to log in. So to do that, you need username, as I said before. Root username comes as a default and password is the one that you set up. So check means whether your password is correct or not, your credentials are correct or not. So here you see connection successful. That means, okay, the credential is good. Let's go next and execute them. There you go. Finally finished. Click finish and next. Okay, now start MySQL Workbench after setup. Start MySQL Shell after setup. Okay, I want both of them to be started. The Workbench is the visual interface to access the database, and the shell is the command line where you can access database from command line as well. As a professional MySQL developer, you'll need to know both of them in the future. So let's open and quickly have a look how it looks and how you can use them. Click finish. There you go, they both open in my next window. So okay, let's first look into the MySQL Workbench. So this is the UI. So database is somewhere inside the computer that actually you cannot see where the actual data are stored. So to access those data, you need some sort of interface. So this one will connect to your database, or this one will connect to your database to do all the queries and get the data. Okay, here you can see MySQL connection. So this one already have a connection set up. You can do multiple connection if you like. If you have multiple database, or you can even connect your remote database here. We will look into this in the future, so leave it now. So what it's saying here is local instance MySQL 80 is connected as a user root, and of course it's in your local host computer. And 3306 is your port. So just click onto it and it will open the again the authentication window. So put the password that you set up before, save the password in vault so you don't have to put it again and again. So okay, so this is your MySQL Workbench. So you can do a lot of things from here. Basically everything you can do from here. So okay guys, this is what it looks once you are in the actually MySQL Workbench login database. So this one has this workbench has connected to the MySQL server. So this is the administration section. There's a lot of things you can have a look, like the dashboard looks pretty cool, huh? So this one may not make any sense to you at all if you are very new to database, especially with the workbench. Don't worry guys, you will become pro in no time. So okay, that's just don't worry about the administration side. Let's go to schemas. Schemas is basically the database. So think about the schema is the metadata. If you execute that in the SQL, that will create database. So just think about that. So when we choose to install sample data, it has installed view. Tequila CSS system. So there is nothing there. The world. Let's go to. So these are the database. So this is system database. So let's check what's inside. So click here to expand it and click table. You got city, you got country, and you got country language. If you want to see here, let's close this from here. Okay. Just click here and see this icon. This one, you can run this database. So basically when you click that one, it will run. Select everything from the old database, and inside old database it is the table. So these are the one. Okay, so same thing with the country language. You have ready data to play around with them, and every time you do take action here, you can see the actual SQL query language here as well if you don't know like how to type. So there is so much to learn and so much like good stuff here. We will learn fully in the future videos. So this is how you access and all your database administration from here. Now let's okay, this one has connected to your database MySQL server. Let's open the MySQL command line client. I want to minimize this. Okay, this is the client. So you need to put password. By default, it is going to log in as a root user. So put the password that you have set up before. That means you are logged in. If you see this one information, you are logged into the MySQL server version 8.0.2. So every time you do new, every time you connect, it will give you a new ID. So I can show you that by connecting one more time. See, it was 21 ID before, now it gets to 22. Okay, just close it. Alright, so let's see what are the database there. So the way you use command line is by running actually SQL query language. So do so databases. These are the table. Remember you saw in the MySQL workbench. So these are the table. Okay, let's say we looked into world. So if you want to see what are the table inside the world, we go and say use world. So it will say since. Let me make it bigger font. Okay, when you say use the database that you want to use, it will change the database to that database you want to use. So now let's see what are the table inside the database. Just type the tables. So these are the tables. So if you want to see actually what data inside the, let's say city table, you do select everything, determine everything from city. and hit enter. Wow, that's too big. I didn't realize that. Okay, just hit Ctrl C to stop. And let's select only like 10 cities. So to select city, let's do select everything from city and limit to 10 cities. You can get this density. So this is how you can use command line client to access your database. If you really want to become pro in MySQL, I recommend using command lines client more often than using the workbench. So as a beginner, of course, you want to use workbench as well to get familiarize yourself. But this is definitely you need to do in the future. Okay, guys, that is all for the MySQL setup now.
Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like this video. I'll be creating more video for web development in the future. If you are interested in web development, please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon and make sure to turn on the notification so that you'll receive all the my future tutorials. If you want to install MongoDB in Windows, check this video. And if you want to install the Redis database, check this video. See you next time.